He's a pinball wizard. There has to be a twist. A pinball wizard got such a super wrist.
Greetings and salutations, fellow news hounds and listeners. This is Mr. Toffee here with this week's Wrapsody. Let's keep it a bit brief, more so than usual. We have a lot in store later this month and the next. Trust us, you wouldn't want to miss out what we'll be showing. But enough about the future, let's dive right to the present. Who indeed? The first ever Southeast Asian Olympic-level medal-based esports tournament has come and gone. Here are your winners. The Philippines won gold medals for Dota 2, StarCraft 2, and Mobile Legends.
Thailand
won 2 gold medals, one for Arena of Valor and one for Tekken 7. They also won 1 silver for Hearthstone. Malaysia won 1 gold medal for Hearthstone as well as 1 bronze for Mobile Legends. All in all, a great celebration of esports and a nice shape of things to come. Congratulations to all the teams and countries who won and participated in this momentous occasion. We, as sporting Malaysians, would also like to congratulate our neighbours in Singapore for their silver and bronze medal wins for StarCraft 2 and Hearthstone. Sorry to hear that your media is giving you a rough time. From the bottom of our hearts, the fact that you are out there fighting your damnedest is proof that you deserve better. Like we said last episode, RE3 is a thing. Now it has a release date, the 3rd of April 2020. Also, Jill Valentine ditches the awkward 90s skirt for proper jeans for fighting that ever pesky and persistent nemesis.
Stars.
If you are already missing that look, you can get a DLC pack for that via the RE3 Collector's Edition, filled with tons of stuff for your table and shelf. We're just glad Capcom is on the roll with announcements like these. Makes us wonder if they'll be announcing a new fighting game once this year's Capcom Pro Tour is over and done with. Kill Bill Volume 1 and 2. Epic tributes to 70s Shaw films of yore, and usually in everybody's top 5 list of best Quentin Tarantino films. So it's with great joy to announce that his 10th movie may be a sequel to Kill Bill. In an interview with radio host Andy Cohen, Tarantino seems to be actively exploring ideas for a Kill Bill Volume 3. Even recently meeting up with the bride herself, Uma Thurman. He was thinking of exploring the question of what happened to the protagonist since Volume 2's ending. Since he wants to make that a masterpiece, it will be a while until that film happens. At least 3 years from now. And if that doesn't pan out, at least we'll get that swear-laden, ultra-violent Star Trek movie we've always wanted. Warner Brothers has announced the release date of The Matrix 4 along with several other movies. What's amazing here is that Keanu's return to the Matrix universe is set to release on the same day as John Wick 4. That's right, both Matrix 4 and John Wick 4 are coming out on the 21st of May 2021. It seems that Matrix 4 is taking over the slot that was previously occupied by the live-action Akira adaptation. Unfortunately, that project was put on hold indefinitely back in July. This was due to the production period clashing with the filming of Thor: Love and Thunder. In any case, with two possibly great movies featuring Keanu Reeves coming out at the same time, the 21st of May should really be declared a public holiday after 2021. Since, you know, it's going to be those days where you and your pals watch one movie, then proceed to the next one in the same theater.
Oh great!
Who won the Game Awards 2019? Jeff Keighley, that's who. Nah, I'm just kidding. It's actually us, the gamers, the fans, the players. Finally, we actually have a nominated Game Awards video game that deserves its GOTY status. Sekiro: Shadows Die Twice. This from Software Gem won Best Game of 2019 at the tail end of the show. PC indie RPG darling Disco Elysium won 4 awards, while divisive Kojima title Death Stranding won 3 awards. Oh yeah, and there were also a bunch of reveals and trailers, like the next-gen Microsoft console Xbox Series X, the launch date of Ghost of Tsushima, a League of Legends side game, a new Bravely Default RPG for the Switch, more awkward Ikumi Nakamura hijinxes.
Here are the nominees for Best Art Direction Art. Internet.
And more No More Heroes 3. Check out our website for all of that noise. That's all the highlights for this week. Until then, that's the way the world pixelates.